So, hello everyone. I'm ready so far. So everything Stefan said about the development process at ZDays is true. I was there. It was really bad, and the office was built once a week. Yeah, you had to work on the built office for 1 week without incompatible changes. It was a nightmare. Okay. So welcome to Hidden Gems in Draw Impress part two, because part one was held by me in Brno in LibreOffice conference. There's a video you can check. So I will not repeat part one. Maybe I will do some parts from part one, but you don't need part one to know now. You will maybe see some techniques I will be using, which will, if you are interested, you can check the video and you will see how it works. So the echo was very positive, so I decided to continue that and to do something again, because time was fleeting at the time and I had much too less time to show. Same as today, it's just 20 minutes, so there's no chance to get through it. I will just do the most interesting stuff and try to do the second half of part one, which I was not able to show, something like that. So thankfully some community members did some wiki pages and interesting stuff. Thanks for that. I try to support and read it. Very good that this popped up, and I got a lot of feedback and requests after the Brno presentation, and I hope more people are using the mostly underestimated Draw application, because Draw, of course, in an office package which you download to do something special, you don't think about using it as a Draw program. But it's pretty mighty, you will see. So today just 20 minutes and I will sit down and use the mouse when I show you the stuff. So I will try to switch between the presentation and showing something. If the screen goes off, just tell me. I will try to fix it. So text in orange can be referred in original presentation, so I will try to go over it. So just a short review. Basic knowledge of the graphic object stuff. Draw and Impress is the same module and program. I'm not sure if you know. It's just a question of configuration. So together with Writer and Calc and the other programs, using the Draw objects, you have a pretty decent chance that it's 100% compatible. So the best way to work on graphics or geometry stuff for Calc and Writer and Impress is to copy it to Draw and to copy it back in when you are done. So this will work in most all cases. So I don't give guarantees, but as far as I know, it works pretty good. So there are a lot of advanced features which are quite hidden and often not very intuitive, so that's the reason why I decided to just show what you can do. So let's start with something obvious, the object selection and set order and stuff like that. You will know that. Oh yeah, by the way, I have added, where is it? In Brno, the guy said I would need a tool that you can watch the keyboard actions I'm executing, because you don't see that. So and exactly now it's not really working. And I'm using this Karnek tool. It's pretty nice, very easy. Yeah, there it is. So you will see on the right lower side, and you can follow later in the video which is recorded, if you want to know exactly what if you want to see exactly what key presses I was using, stuff like that. So why does this not went away? Go away. Why does this not go away? Should go away. Go away. Does not go away. Okay. you see first problems with this combination of stuff. Let's see. I've not tested this with a projector if it's working. I want to get rid of this toolbar. Oh no. Sorry. Okay. I don't know how to get rid of it, so you will have to live with it for the moment. So the first thing is navigating between objects. You know this with shift and shift tab and tab, no problem. Object selection, Z order, how to select covered objects, it's an interesting point. Just imagine these objects would be really behind each other, so how do you select the object behind it? Many people ask this in bug reports or something. You can just use the alternate key, and if you press, you can walk through objects which lie behind each other. So this is really good to get quickly through object selections if you don't want to navigate too much. And with shift combined, you can go the backward direction. You have the arrange toolbar, should be pretty clear. The usual stuff to arrange all the objects. Not much to say about that, but you have curve tools and traveling, and it's all keyboard accessible. Many people don't know that, and using the keyboard controls can give you a lot of extra control. For example, you can move with shift, you can move faster with control. You always move the view, it always stays, and with Alt key you can move pixel-wise. And this pixel-wise is interestingly, it's of course dependent of your zoom. So the deeper you zoom in, the finer you can move. Very interesting if you have to do very exact working stuff. And you can even change the curve if you... Yeah. All the same.
The after is to go back to the zoom.
Yeah. This is full zoom. All the zoom commands have shortcuts on the keyboard. You can just check in the program. You can look afterwards, and you can check in the commands in the office. It's all documented, so you can work pretty much everything with the keyboard. You see, I use Control Tab. I can start with Escape again to start newly. With Tab and Shift Tab, I can change with the curves, and with Control Tab, I can select the first point and just move the first point with the same commands. With next Control Tab, I get to the next point, and with Escape, I get back. And when I go to a curve and press F8 to get to the curve mode, I can do exactly the same. I can work with the curve. So now you say it's a curve, no problem. I can select the point, and you can travel over the control point. So you have complete control with the keyboard, and when you combine it with the Alt key to move pixel-wise, you can really do extreme fine navigation stuff. So just as a tip. So... underestimated helpers, color bar. I very, very briefly for the color bar. It's in few toolbars. You have the color bar down there. It appears like something like that. And you can change all colors of all objects anytime. So for example, I make the line a little bit wider. You it gets the color you select, and with the right mouse you can change the line color, which is very fast and intuitive, and you can even drag and drop the colors over to objects. So if you need to create some objects very quickly, for example, you have an ellipse and you copy it by pressing Control, and you want some different colors, you can, the fastest way I know is just to drag and drop them in. Something like that. So just to make your work easier. Controlled movement, I already told about the arrow keys and qualifiers. And then we have grid helplines while moving, you know all that stuff, I think. But what's very interesting and not very well known is the helpline stuff. Just imagine you go to this object and you want to
slash.
Huh? Slash is zooming the selected object optimal to the screen. It's just one of the shortcuts. So when you want to align this object with one of the objects much lower in the screen, what you can do, for example, is you can drag out a helpline from the rulers. I don't know if you know about that, because when you go down, then you can align the objects easily and work with objects which are not in your view. So when you are working a lot with zooming in, zooming out, this is very handy. And zooming in, zooming out should be one of your preferred actions in Draw, because it allows you to work in much more detail than when not using it. And the menu point is not visible now because I don't get rid of this stupid bar, but there's also a main point to switch on and off all the helplines. And you can do as many of them as you wish, and you can change them, of course, and you can even get an UI for them if you want to position them somewhere exactly. So it's a very decent tool to do very exact work if you want, something like that. If you want to get rid of it, just put it back in the ruler. That's all. So, multiple ways to multiply objects. So often to generate some geometry, you want to multiply objects. So one of the easiest ways is just to use copy paste your shift key, put it to the side. Copy paste again, select all first, copy paste shift key again, copy paste shift key again, very easy. So allows you to quickly do some geometry from basic ground geometry stuff. So this again you can use, for example, to combine with other shapes to get some interesting XOR stuff, or if you don't want to combine, you can use the other logic operations which I will show in a moment. So that's one possibility. The other possibility I don't know if you have ever used it. There's a duplicate dialog. I will use it's a fast access, and you can just say that your shape should be rotated and moved and something like that. And if you do this with multiple shapes, first horizontal, then vertically, you can pretty much do the same faster if you want color changes and stuff like that. Very easy, very fast if you need some geometry. Of course, I'm doing nothing really planned. I have no real target. It's just to show you the tools which are available to make your work easier. And you can, of course, do combinations of the shown methods. So sources of geometries to work with. This is very interesting. Often you don't know where do I get some graphics from. So the easiest way, one of the easiest ways, is, for example, just type some text, choose your font, and convert to curve. And what you get is a group from the fonts, you can ungroup the stuff, and you can use every single character as geometry to do stuff with it. And this is of course not only true for the normal fonts, but also for the symbol fonts. And there it gets really interesting because all the symbol fonts contain a lot of interesting stuff you can just use to work with to get your graphics. One of the sources. The other source is of course the gallery, and what's even possible nowadays and works pretty well is drag and drop from the web browser. So if you have a web browser, just go back and forth and drag your stuff over. It will be converted to formats as good as possible. So vector is preferred, of course, over pixel. So everything in the office tries to stay on vector format today. So that's anyways a huge progress from old days. So object sculpturing. I wanted to show what you can do when you just need to create something which is not in the predefined stuff. For example, by the way, double click on the button lets you do repeated create options. Create actions as long as the tool is active, something like that. But the interesting part is, not the above one. This tool showing the stuff makes it very slow. But I will just merge these two shapes, and if you have your basic t-shirt, you can use an ellipse. Select all. It's slow again. Subtract it. And you can go even further with working with just sculpturing using the add and subtract functionality. It's so mighty because if you check what internally happens, you can see that the quality stays on curve level as far as possible. So I don't know if any other office program is capable of doing that, but you can work with geometry intuitively and on high quality level because it's not converted to an array of points. It stays on curve level if you cut out curve stuff like that. So that's very useful. And what you can even do, we'll show a short example. It's so slow. With this tool in the background. I'm sorry for the speed. I wanted to do it as fast as possible. So you can do something like that. Use these shapes, subtract to make you a stamp object or something, whatever you need. And you can then apply your stamp wherever you want. You get the idea, I'm sure. Oh, what happened? Something like that. It's still on curve level, everything on curve level. You can, of course, combine this with freeform curves. So if you just want to subtract something from a shape which you have. Oh, already? Oh my God.
Two more minutes.
Okay. Let's do something else. Very interesting point, which I think you should know. It's the fill style of objects. So, for example, here I just have three normal circles. Copy them once here, copy them once there. So then the left I convert to a bitmap object and the write I convert into a meta file. So now I can use this object. It's also very unknown when you go to the drag and drop mode and use Control and Shift, you can use any object you have on your screen to fill another object. So makes your work very easy, and you can get rid of your stamp object after you have used the fill. But what I want to show is when you use this, you have a huge difference, of course, between the vector fill and the meta file fill. So what you can do now in the office for quite some time is not to fill with bitmaps, and the fill style which says bitmaps is changed to graphic, because you can use any graphic. You can fill your objects with SVG and with meta files, and that way your fill style will be resolution independent, and if you export it to PDF you will get a decent extreme well quality. So there's lot of stuff to show, to go on, but sorry, have to be next time. So 20 minutes is definitely too short.